Hey, what's up, everyone? Raging Golden Eagle here, having way too much fun, as always. And today, I bring to you a pretty hilarious article that was brought to my attention by Turd-Flinging Monkey. Though I'm not going to be as savage as he was. The headline should give you an indication of what you're in for. Commitment-phobic men are the real reason women are having children later. And this is from a conservative newspaper, The Spectator. And you know what? I'm not just going to re-right off the bat. Because this statement is actually partially correct. For the first few paragraphs, she goes into how women, for the most part, know it's better to have children sooner rather than later, which is at least half true. For every, let's just say, highly promiscuous woman that just sleeps around and acts as if her youth and beauty will last forever that I've known, there's also been one that was trying to settle down. So if even these women that are trying to settle down are having a problem, then it must be the men, right? Well, the author seems to think so. I hate to kick men when they're down, ducked beneath the parapet for fear of angry feminists, but I suspect the real problem here isn't ignorant girls, but unwilling boys. That one is phrased a whole lot better. And this just shows how effective word choice is. Just replace commitment phobic with unwilling, and all of a sudden the statement rings a whole lot more true. Because she's not incorrect here. Boys and men are simply unwilling to play the game anymore. And while the author spends pretty much the entire article complaining about this, she seems to put no thought into why. If online dating turns more men into commitment phobes, I don't see why anyone should be surprised. It's women for the most part who feel the urge to nest and breed, as we all once quite freely acknowledged before gender became a choice. Ooh, that was a nice hit right there, I'm gonna give you that one. Most men don't feel the same need to play house. It took the threat of public shame, fear of God, and the censorious tutting of mutual friends to chivy a man towards family life. Online dating strangers, who's to see or care? There's actually plenty to get into in this paragraph right here. She mentioned that it's women for the most part who feel the need to nest and breed. And on the flip side of that, it's men for the most part that feel the need to constantly get their dick wet. Which is something that, unless we're gay, we generally need a woman for. But using the power between our ears, we found alternatives that are a lot more cost-effective and a lot less risky. I think it's about time you women do the same. But this here's the big one. It took the threat of public shame, fear of God, and the censorious tutting of mutual friends to drive a man towards family life. That is a fair statement. But you seem to either not realize or are completely glossing over the fact that this worked both ways. This same threat of public shame and fear of God, and the community ostracizing you, that was also used to stop women from abandoning their families because I'm not happy anymore. Yet for some reason, I don't see you complaining about that. And in this case, I'm not just saying this as a cheap shot to score some cheap points. This is a very important point to make, because don't you think men would be a lot more willing to take a risk if it came with a little bit of insurance? You seem to have no problem with the fact that in the past, all of these things were used to basically force men into a relationship that they don't want. Yet I wonder if you have that same attitude when it comes to women also being forced to stay in that relationship that they don't want. As I've been mentioning countless times in my videos since the dawn of this channel, the primary reason men are walking away from relationships in general and marriage in particular is because over time we are constantly being stripped of all the benefits we used to enjoy with that arrangement, while more and more and more risks just keep being tacked on. And also, like I mentioned before, imagine if this was happening at your job. Imagine if you kept getting a pay cut every year, meanwhile your work was proportionately increasing, and the time you have to stay there also increasing at the same rate as your pay was decreasing. How long would you stay there before you at least stop to think, maybe I should look for better options, because this is not working out. If you want to understand men's views on marriage, that right there, I think, is a pretty good analogy. Just view marriage as the job. The rewards we get for being married are, well, the paycheck that's now decreasing, and the risks we take and all the stress it generates are obviously the work itself, which keeps increasing. Different guys have different breaking points, but for everybody, there's only so much they'll tolerate. But we'll get back to this towards the end. Let's see what this woman has to say about modern men. Where I live, on the fault line between Islington and Hackney, the coffee shops are full of young people, of perfect breeding age according to the FEI, discussing their lives. I sit spider-like and listen, and I found to my slight horror that all the hallmarks of the old feckless narcissist are present in more than half of the men I overhear. And this is the point I want you guys to pay attention. She's referring to modern men right now. But think of who these comments, in general, normally represent. There is an over-concern with grooming, hair, beard, tattoos. Then, after they've arranged their avocado egg toast and photographed it for Instagram, the endless talk about themselves. They begin. The thing about me is, then there's no stopping them. Yeah, I just kind of had to throw this in there before finishing because I find this hilariously ironic. She's annoyed that men are now acting like women, and points out that this is narcissistic behavior. I guess it is easy to see when someone else is doing it, huh? Well, a lot easier than it is when you're doing it. But again, you just have to ask yourself why. Why are these guys like this? Could it possibly be the fact that since they've been born and in the school system, they've been told that masculinity is toxic and men are the problem and everything masculine is evil and everything feminine is good? Might that have an effect on how they choose to act? And that's not even considering the group of people who fall into my camp. We're not trying to attract a mate. We just don't give a shit anymore. We do what we want. So if these guys just happen to be into fashion and grooming, yeah, I may make fun of them a little bit for it, but hey, it's their life. They could do what they want. So with gender dynamics as they are now, is there any hope at all for recovery in the future? At this point, I have to say that's entirely up to women. Because guys as a whole have looked over the landscape and have realized the juice ain't worth the squeeze. We got better things to do. So if you ladies want to bring the guys back, you gotta make it worth their while. Forget all of the emotional bullshit you've been taught since you've been born. Don't look at it on an emotional level. Look at it from a rational economic level. Look at it from the point of a cost-benefit analysis. If you can, look at it from the guy's point of view. What is it he gets from being in a relationship with you that he can't get cheaper elsewhere? And what risks does that entail? And also, if you can, try to consider what he actually wants. And I know this may be painful for you to hear, but this is the truth of the state of things right now. As the author of this article pretty much said, there's still a lot that women want from men, but they can't seem to get because the men aren't willing to give it up. But look at it on the flip side. Why would men make that trade? The way things are now, women don't really have what men want that they can't just get cheaper elsewhere. So before I sign off, women, maybe just look at it this way. You're trying to buy a new car with a $10 bill. You desperately want that car. You may need that car. But that car is worth a whole lot more than a $10 bill to the owner of that car. If you want him to give you that car, you gotta give him something that he thinks is worth it. And if you can't do that, then don't worry, you don't have to go for your cats just yet. Because I am not lying when I say that every single woman I've ever met, no matter how unattractive or how horrible of a personality she had, always had at least one guy that was trying to suck up to her. Chances are there is a guy very close to your life that would be more than happy to have you if this is the type of stuff you want. But you view that guy the same way the guys you want view you. Think about that for a second. And that's all I gotta say, guys. Thanks for listening.